Override SMC lockdown. SMC lockdown override sent.
I fear that I will become numb to these incessant horrors.
What they did here is inexcusable.
And for the basest of reasons.
They knew, Captain. Spacer's Choice knew all along what Adrenatime did, and they sold it anyway.
I know. I can't believe they did this.
You are the master of understatement, Captain.
Maybe Miss Ambrose can help fix things once she's cleared her family name. She could hold the board's feet to the fire. Make them pay.
What do you guys keep looking at when someone else talks? Each other? There's only one way to find out where this leads. Come on. Okay, now I'm nervous that he's sending stuff at me. Vid screen not turning on. So surprised.
What they did here? I ain't ever gonna shake this.
Mm-mm. You're very sensitive, Parvati. Here's the facility rear exterior, which we've been to. Quiet. All right. What am I doing? I wanted to... Yeah. Ah! Pain reminds you you're alive. I just gotta repair my weapons. I think I'm going to the mines next, though.
Hey again, stranger. What can I get you? All sorts of salvage and weapons. And plenty of.
Yep, I have plenty of as well. How good is that? That's pretty interesting attributes, but I'm not going to keep it. The pressurized injection suit uses a series of pressurized mechanical syringes to feed precise dosages of liquid components directly into the test subject's bloodstream at multiple points throughout the body. It's all very scientific. Oh my god. The injection mask completely covers the airways of the subject, allowing for exacting control of gas compositions used in the experiments. Many subjects report that this helmet doesn't feel suffocating. Well, they're out of their minds, usually, so we can't really rely on that. 103, let me look at that. This is better. I don't like her in such bulky stuff. I mean, this... It's not really much of a difference, is it? It is more bulky. Alright, so we'll sell the elite troop armor gold. And what am I wearing? Oh, I'm using this. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with that.
Hey again, stranger.
The shame I've tinkered this up so high. Still wonder. Dodge and stealth skills. Oh well. Some of these duplicates. All right, got money again. We can tinker. We can repair. So I need to repair this stuff. Modify. Yeah, I can't modify my stuff, but so this is hers, right? Install mod, okay. Upgrades body armor. Okay, that's good. So I can put one each, right? Now here we have a gadget. This mod stuns and damages melee attackers. Chrono field. Well, that's not going to be for help on friends. Increases movement speed. When your health drops too low, this mod pushes back all nearby enemies. That sounds great. Skill kit. Range weapon skills. Same. Dialogue. Melee weapon. Oh, what about that secret? Oh, I never got into that door. Next, yeah, I never found a way into that door at the HIA. I had a 150 to get through, and I don't have that. I wonder what was in there. Armor mod. Weapon skills. Tech skills. Melee weapon defense skills, that's gotta be good. Yeah. And then utility. Sprint speed, would that even help with companions? Sprint speed, I guess. Alright. Okay, so that's hers. And now his. He already has factory Stark armor plating. We'll leave that as is. Range weapon skills and I don't think this is useful. Their armor doesn't degrade. Maybe just the sneaking. I guess. Alright. And then... I'm already completely modded on my gun here. Assault rifle ultra, yeah, modded here. Light assault rifle, okay. Increases rate of fire, that's gotta be good. Critical damage. Yeah, rate of fire, I guess. And then magazine. Corrosion. Magazine size. Post-armor damage dealt. That's gotta be good too. Okay. So that's that. Assault rifle. Look at the DPS on that. That's insane. Wow. And then we got this one. Critical damage. I don't want any of these. Change to corrosion, yeah, I'd rather not. Okay, I'm gonna leave that one as is. And let's see if we can tinker anything. Insufficient bits. Insufficient. I can tinker the other assault rifle, leaving not much left. I could tinker this that I just given her. Or the helmet, yeah, let's do this. Got that power armor now, man. 148. Okay, we're done there. Yeah, I was going to check with him, see if he's got some mods.
Hey again, stranger. What can I get you? All sorts of...
There's one I don't want. I have two of them. I missed it somehow. Didn't I have two of a plasma or something? Here. Yeah. Alright, let's see what mods you got. Not much. Increases attack speed. That's a melee weapon mod. Reduces noise. Increases weapon accuracy. I don't know if this is even helpful for companions. Alright, so I'm just going to modify the other tinker the other assault rifle. Mark 3. Because we got this. Where is it? Mark 3. Yeah, that's up to 169. Oh, no, it's currently 164. So now we can make this one 164. Alright, done. Oh, let's return to him. I have to go back up. I dropped down. No, that's the problem. Okay, here we go. Is this up to the Sprat Shack? Don't stand under there. To this guy in here. Because we have all his recordings. Apparently we have to go to Stellar Bay to deliver another one. Or more. I wish we could take it right to that floor. We have to run up to... somewhere. I think it's the top level.
So, how you feeling?
Good. Real good, like someone's shining a light behind my eye.
That's real good, huh? What's it say? NTVUR? I don't know why it says that. Roscoe. Second floor. Guess what I got?
Hey, there you are. Been wondering how you were doing.
Hanging in there.
Did you manage to find those recordings?
Can I ask you something?
Sure, I'm an open book.
What's the deal with Lucky Montoya?
Nice enough guy. Fashioned himself one of those professional gumshoes, like in the serials. They usually work for the board, rooting out dissidents and the like. Lucky, though, he was freelance. Worked for anyone who paid, no matter their allegiance. You ask me, I think the guy just likes snooping around in folks' terminal messages.
Well, his luck ran out. Lex sent me his arm in the mail. Did she tell you that?
No, but I'd wager Lex there's a lot of weird shit she doesn't tell anyone about. That's the sublight way.
Huh.
Gotta say, though, mailing a stranger some dead guy's arm probably tops the list. At least I'd hope so.
Yeah, me too. What was Gorgon like in its heyday?
Frenetic, chaotic, vicious. Take your pick. I wasn't here at the start, but going off what folks told me about the early days, Gorgon started out with promise. The board's best and brightest were excited to work here. Said it was a good posting. The project director had a vision and big, bold ideas.
Their best and brightest sure got a lot of people killed.
As long as the board gets their bits, that's just the cost of doing business.
Mm-hmm.
Thing is, the schedules coming out of the corporate office were unrealistic from the get-go. And they were trying to do the project on a shoestring budget. Couple that with the obvious personnel problems and toxic junk in the product, it was only a matter of time before it all went to hell.
Was that when the Marauders appeared?
Could have been, yeah. Marauders didn't just fall out of the sky one day. They were made here on Gorgon. How, though? That's the question.
Oh, I know how.
Brad Shack legend has it they crawled out of the mines one day. Heard one fella suggest they might even be aliens.
But you know different.
I think the drug they were developing here turned people into marauders.
Mm-hmm.
Not on purpose, mind, but over time. Marauderhood's not the flu. It ain't contagious and they don't reproduce. So how else would they get all over the colony?
Not an unreasonable theory, and definitely not out of the realm of possibility for a Spacer's Choice product.
I don't have proof, mind. It's just a hunch.
Gorgon's a ruin now. What sent it over the edge?
Shit, any number of things. Fire, primals, sabotage. It didn't happen all at once, but it happened fast enough folks couldn't respond in time. Now, if you're asking how it all kicked off, might have been spies that did it. Corporate espionage, you know. Anti-Cleos.
Hmm.
I never did figure it out. Not about to try now.
You must have talked to a lot of the staff here. What were they working on?
Adrenotime. I'm sure you know it.
Yeah.
It was a drug, something to make folks work harder, work smarter. Had a lot of nasty side effects. Didn't seem so bad to me at the time, but then I hadn't met the test subjects yet. The whole thing was real hush-hush. A lot of worry about corporate spies, especially from Anticleos.
Right.
I probably shouldn't even be mentioning it to you, to be honest. Spacer's Choice, they're really not fond of spies.
Who is?
Fair point. Not even spies like spies.
What do you know about the senior researchers?
Not much, except that there was a whole gaggle of them, and so far as I could tell, they absolutely hated each other.
Yep.
Dr. Ambrose would hardly let me speak to any of them, but she complained about him all the time.
What did she complain about?
Everything, seemed like. Marion Blakesley, for example, lady who ran HIA, wouldn't return any of her messages. Not once, for years. Jasper Lowe, guy who headed up Chem, was high more than he was sober. He insisted on running special tests on primals, too. Law knows what for.
Yeah, we saw that. Anyone else?
Dr. Ambrose really had it out for this guy Lawrence Goodfellow. Ran OCI. Would lose his shit if he saw red on a schedule. By the end, I heard folks were turning in completely bunk progress reports just to keep him out of their hair. Had this little minion, too. An actuary named Clarence Mostly. Obsessed with quantifying every detail of his sad little life.
Yeah.
Mostly was the guy who got me mixed up in all this. Asshole. I hope a primal ate him.
Nope, he's alive and well. On, what's it called? Can't remember the name now. The rich people's area. Oh, it's killing me. It's on the tip of my tongue, guys. I know what it is, so you don't have to write comments saying what it is, because by then, I'll have remembered. It'll come to me once I stop thinking about it. Yeah. Alright. So there was tension between the researchers?
Oh, yeah. It wasn't just that Dr. Ambrose hated them. They seemed to hate each other, too. OCI pushed a ludicrous schedule. Chem made a bad product. And HIA returned garbage results. A regular merry-go-round of shit flying in every direction. It's no surprise it all fell apart.
Byzantine.
The surprise is that it didn't happen sooner.
I know you're half-jesting, mister, but it's even worse than you say.
That's not becoming on her.
My editor said my prose was too purple. And here I could have gone vermilion.
Byzantium, so I was trying to think of. Alright.
Not a problem. Anything else?
Yeah, I found all the phonographs.
Well, I'll be damned. Now I can finally get off this rock and go home. I know it's not much, but take the last of my bits. You've earned every single one, friend.
Wall of Swords. Okay, so we didn't return one to Georgie. I don't know why we would care. To go all the way back to the Groundbreaker, just deliver some of them there? And then the rest of Roscoe? Would they all go to the automechanical? I have no idea. Maybe we get a better reward? I have no clue. Was there something going on between you and Georgie?
No, I mean, I don't know.
You don't know?
Sometimes it seemed like there could be, when we were servicing the phonographs, sharing a beer, but who'd be interested in some forgotten old bastard like me?
Takes all kinds.
Sure, yeah. My ma used to say the same thing. And anyway, unauthorized fraternization between employees is illegal. But that's all you need to know about my dire love life, I think. Any other horrible truths you want to reveal to me? Or can I get back to my drinking?
Your dire love life. So it's like any other love life, only it's dire. Did you know that Georgie was interviewing Olivia Ambrose on her own?
She couldn't have been. We were together all the time. Except, oh shit, my weekly calls with headquarters. What could she even want to ask Olivia Ambrose about? Doesn't make sense.
Production details, ratios and measurements, ingredients, that kind of thing.
Good fucking law. Headquarters would kill me if they knew right after they killed her. Hell, being stuck here might have been the only thing keeping me alive.
I don't have any more details, sorry.
Listen, I appreciate you telling me what happened with those recordings, but I need some time to think. Got a lot to process.
You do that, buddy.
Yeah, I'll just... yeah. See you around.
See you around.
I don't think I can stomach working for the board again.
I don't blame you. Coming through. Does Lex have anything new to say?
You're not gonna believe this, but Leonora paid her tab and told me she won't be coming back. I'll miss her, but she deserves a classier joint anyway.
True.
She left with a spring in her step. Told me to thank you on her way out. Something tells me she's gonna be all right.
I hope so.
Have a round on me.
Well, thanks. Anything new here?
Spacer's Choice used to brew pharmaceuticals in these parts. They say Adrena Time came from here. Just down the road at the old R&D lab. You got it, bub. Be seeing you.
Okay. Just checking in with everybody. We're going to the mines next. Because I want to grab that last clue, that last comic. So we can, get into that secret headquarters that they have.
Any trouble I should know about? Watch yourself out there.
Oops. Tartarus. Oh, it's made this... okay. So now that we've locked this down, synthesis and manufacturing center should be in Olivia's office at the very top of the center. Which is... here. SMC lower exterior. Okay, but first we're going to the mines. So we can get the last piece. Here of the puzzle, and then we get into here, the secret hideout. So I think we can, yeah, be quicker just to fast travel to OCI lower exterior and just run here. We have not been over here yet, and I think this is an atmospheric, a terraformer or atmospheric condenser or whatever they call it. Basically to make the planet habitable for human life and whatever else. So it'll be the mines, the secret hideout, and then finally the synthesis and manufacturing center. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.